I've been waiting for this for a long time, so let's unbox the Ally X.
Getting into the box, I see the Ally X all wrapped up here. I find a quick start guide, a 65-watt power delivery charger, power cable, two paper stands, the Ally X. Let me tell you the recommended settings you change in my setup guide so that you can get the best experience out of this wonderful device. Hi, I'm Captain Awesome, this is Geekception, and I really hope you hit that like button and subscribe as it really helps me out here on the channel. And the setup for the Ally X here was fairly straightforward. I plugged in power, I turned it on, I went through Windows. And one thing I did during the setup, which I recommend you do, is to set up the fingerprint unlock here on the Ally X. It's one of the most easiest and fastest ways to get into your Ally X. I can immediately feel how nice the Ally X is in the hand. I can definitely feel that this is a bit more chunkier and heavier in my hand. And to start my setup guide, first let's do some housekeeping. One of the first things I usually do is clean up my taskbar. And to adjust the taskbar settings, press and hold on the taskbar. Then tap on taskbar settings. I recommend you turn off widgets and Windows Copilot. Scroll down to taskbar behavior and tap on the arrow to expand it, and then move the taskbar from the center to the left. I find that this gives me more space on my taskbar compared to the center, which takes up too much space and limits the apps and games that I can see on the taskbar at any one time. Next, let's go into the Microsoft Store, then update all the apps because some will definitely be outdated. So head into the library, and once it loads, tap on get updates at the top right. And with the purchase of the Ally, you also get 3 months of free Xbox Game Pass, which I'm going to claim right now. And while all the apps are downloading, I'll head into Microsoft Edge and download some of my favorite apps on the Ally X. First, I'll download and install Steam. Next, I'll download and install the Epic Games Launcher. And that's pretty much it for the apps I always install first, because again, this is a gaming device, so gaming apps always take precedence. Next, let's set up Armoury Crate, which is the app you use to manage both your games and your Ally X as well. Now press the Armoury Crate button, agree to all of the agreements. And once you're in Armoury Crate, go all the way to the right where you'll find the update center. Tap check for updates to see if there are any new updates. And since I see several new updates, I'll click on update all. Now I got an update for Armoury Crate itself, so I let it update first and then I relaunch it when it was done updating. Now I want you to go back into the update center, and since there are still some updates pending here, click on update all. This will download and install all the updates from Armoury Crate, which you absolutely want to do. Next, let's open the MyASUS app. And I recommend you change a few settings here. First, agree to the MyASUS agreement by clicking next. Enter the home page where you'll see information like the memory status, the battery status, the CPU load, and more. And what I want you to do is tap on the device settings. And before that, you will notice a notification for new updates. If it were like me, then it will automatically update and you don't have a choice. The app will relaunch. Anyway, tap on device settings and it will give you some options here. Tap on battery care mode, which ensures that your Ally X doesn't charge beyond 80%. And why we are turning this on is so that you can save your battery health in the long run, because this is a handheld gaming console and most of your time, maybe sometimes you're plugging it in and you're just leaving it plugged in. You don't want your battery life to degrade just because it's plugging all the time. So having a 80% cap just makes sure that your battery health is just going to be safe from quick degradation. Next, in the MyASUS app, tap on the system update tab and you'll see several updates waiting for you. If not, you can tap on check for updates to find if there are any pending updates. I recommend you tap on update selected items to update your Ally X. And part of this update might be a BIOS update, which will boot your Ally X into the BIOS to be able to perform the update. Make sure you just have it plugged in so that it doesn't die while performing the BIOS update. Now, just a quick fun fact is that the old Ally stand, which is the white one here, does not actually fit the new Ally and vice versa. And I tested it out, putting the old one in the new one and the new one on the old one, and it did not work. So in case you thought you could interchange your Ally, if you have an Ally already, it doesn't work. Fun fact. Now let's customize the command center on the Ally X with some essential icons and shortcuts here. Start by pressing the Armoury Crate button, and this will launch Armoury Crate. From the Armoury Crate home screen, switch to the next tab and then go to edit command center. And on the right, you can add several options to the command center. Now here's what I'm going to add. End task, which will help you end the current application, which is useful in terms of unresponsive applications or games. AFMF, which is the AMD fluid motion frames, which will allow you to even get more frames out of your games. Let me know if you want a tutorial for this in the future. Refresh rate, that lets you change the refresh rate of the Ally X. And since there's still some space, let us add some extra ones here, such as CPU boost, which is a setting I always want access to occasionally. Resolution, which is another useful option to have, especially if you want to play games at a higher setting but at a lower resolution. And with all of the items in the command center, you can actually move it around, which is great for easier access. So now if you press the command center button, you'll see that all the selected options are available. Let's change the Armoury Crate theme. And now, as I'm still in Armoury Crate, as you can see, I have the light theme on. And if you're wondering how to do it, it's pretty simple. From the main Armoury Crate home screen, go to the next tab. tab, tap on General, and then you can change the theme here from Light, which I've set now, to Dark, which is the default. You can also align it with your system theme, but as for me, I'll set it to Light as I like how it looks. Did you know that you can change the intro animation for Armoury Crate? Well, here's how. You can download more animations that are available from their content platform. All you have to do is tap on Startup Video to see the available options. And there aren't many, but there are some here which I think are also cool. Download cool wallpapers. And speaking of the content platform, go to the third tab where you see the campaign, tap on Content Platform, and there you can see different wallpapers. For example, there's a cool 8-bit CD wallpaper for the ROG, with the only downside being that when you tap Get, you need to log in with your ASUS account. And if you haven't signed up, this can be an issue. However, if you're already logged in, it's a great way to snag cool wallpapers. Get free apps. Also on the third tab, tap on Recommended to see three different recommended apps. Opera GX ROG Edition, which is a customized version of the Opera GX gaming browser. BlueStacks, which is an Android emulator to play Android games on your Ally X. System Mechanic Free, which is a tool to get better performance out of your Ally X. And yes, it's free. There's also a game deals here on the third tab, which you can access by tapping on game deals to get several discounted games here. And the discounts vary, and while they are not as deep as I would like, for example, say on Steam, it's nice to still have all of these options on the Ally X as well. Best performance mode for the Ally X. Next, let's talk about performance. Go to the second tab in Armoury Crate, tap on performance to access several options. And under operating mode, you can change your operating mode from Windows, which is the default, to silent mode, which limits your CPU and GPU power for better battery life in handheld mode at the cost of performance. Performance mode, which provides more performance at 17 watts, a good balance for both power and battery life, especially when you're on the go. Turbo mode, which boosts performance to around 30 watts when you are plugged in, or 25 watts when you're on battery power for ultimate performance. Manual mode, which allows you to adjust settings like fan curves, power settings, to get a little bit more performance out of your Ally X. Next, go to System Stat, and it shows you the system statistics such as your RAM, your storage, your fan speed, and your CPU GPU stats. Next is Eco Assist mode, and this mode offers options to optimize your performance, especially in standby mode. I recommend turning off CPU boost here, because in my experience, the CPU boost can worsen battery life and sometimes even performance as well. And if you remember correctly, we actually set a button for this in the command center for easy access. Lastly, go into GPU settings, and here you can access advanced graphic options such as super resolution and all the other options here. And one settings I especially recommend you change is the memory allocated to GPU to auto. But be aware that this will require a restart, so go ahead and restart your Ally X. It's funny, but I had a bug here where the menu just scrolled indefinitely. Get the best display quality on the Ally X. Now, one thing I do not like that AMD does on the Ally X or even the OG Ally is that when you're on battery life, it changes the screen color to save battery life, which can make the screen look worse than it actually is. So I highly recommend you disable this feature, and here's how to do it. Open the AMD software. You can find it in your start menu or search for it on Windows. And ensure that you're on battery power. So unplug if you are connected to power at this stage. On the AMD software home screen, tap on the gaming tab. Next, tap on display. Scroll until you see very bright on the left, and then disable this setting. This will ensure that your screen and display here on the Ally X looks the same either when it's on battery life or it's plugged in. There will be no difference at all. Get the best sound quality on your Ally X. Here's how. Now first, search for Dolby Access on your Ally X. Then open the Dolby Access app. Once you are inside, go into the settings by tapping on the settings icon. You see different sound modes available, such as dynamic, game, movie, music, and voice. Switch it to the movie mode, as I found that this gives the best sound for the speakers on the Ally X. And of course, you are free to adjust the sound to your own taste using the equalizer settings options available, such as detailed, balance, warm, or off. However, in my experience, the movie mode tends to give the best sound here on the Ally X, so I recommend you choose that one. Now, to boost gaming performance, let's turn off memory integrity. Press the start menu and search for core isolation. Open it and you'll see that memory integrity is turned on. In my case, and most likely in yours as well. What we want to do is turn that toggle off, and this will prompt a Windows security setting. Make sure you tap yes, and you may need to restart your computer for this change to take effect. So tap on restart. You also get another Windows security pop-up. Tap yes again. And after your Ally X has rebooted, you have successfully turned off memory integrity. And from all of my research, this can greatly help with gaming performance here on the Ally X. Turn off virtual machine platform. Another thing that has been known to help the Ally X in gaming performance is to turn off the virtual machine platform. And this does not only apply on the Ally X, but it applies on the original Ally as well. Here's how to do it. Open your Windows Start menu. Enter Windows Features in the search bar. Select the first option, Turn Windows Features On or Off. You'll see several options here, including the virtual machine platform, which is likely already selected. Deselect it and tap on OK at the bottom right. A pop-up will appear to apply the change and ask you to restart the device. Go ahead and restart it. And after the restart, you've successfully turned off the virtual machine platform, which will hopefully give you a big boost in gaming performance. Now, the last and most important tip here on the Ally X, and I cannot stress this enough, is to just download and install and enjoy your games here on this wonderful device. Now, all of these tips and all of this guide are all useless if this just collects dust on your table. So please make sure you install your games, make sure you play all your wonderful games, make sure you have such a good time, because this handheld devices right here, either the Ally X here, which is the updated version, or the Ally original Ally here, are both wonderful devices that will get you gaming in almost any game you want to play with very good frame rates, and apart from frame rates, just memories that you can cherish and enjoy for the long haul. And if you cannot tell, I am super duper excited to finally have the Ally X here in my hands, to finally be gaming again on this Ally X, and to finally be playing all of my favorite games here on the Ally X. So thank you so much for making it all the way to the end of this setup guide. Let me know, what are your thoughts about the Ally X here? Did some of these tips help you? Do you have tips of your own for me to be able to, you know, improve performance, for example, on my Ally X? Please don't be shy. Leave those comments down there below. And speaking of being below there, I also have links to my Patreon to, you know, buy me a cup of coffee if you want to support the kind of work that I do here. These videos really take a long time to make. They take a lot of scripting. They take a lot of research. So I appreciate if you can donate, or even if you cannot donate, if you just leave a like, if you just comment or you subscribe, that will go a long way for me. And most importantly, please make sure you enjoy your games. Make sure you take care of yourself and text me when you get home so that I know you got home safe. I've been your captain of awesome. This is Geekception, and I'll catch you in the next one. Don't forget to stay awesome. Bye.